So, this is it. After 5 years, we've finally come to the end of an era. Nothing is ever going to be the same again. Either you guys are going to be lucky enough to be staying on All Hallows and you're going to be working with Miss Fanshawe and Mr. Carney. It's going to be completely different in 6-1. Or you're going to be going off to somewhere completely new. You're going to be meeting all these new people. Alright, so things are going to be different. You won't have Miss Sarah there. You won't have each other there. It's going to be hard. Leaving is never easy. You guys might remember 12 months ago when I found it incredibly difficult to leave you guys. I got, so we say, a little bit emotional. I can imagine some of you are going to get emotional too then. Why shouldn't you get emotional? All Hallows is an absolutely brilliant place to go to school. I'm sure at times you were dying to leave. I'm sure some of you now are going, oh my God, the time has come. I don't want to leave. I'll miss this place. The people you will have met in All Hallows are amazing. You guys are amazing. The support you gave to each other has been fantastic. Some of the teachers you will have met this year, I can imagine this really stressful, difficult year, you will have had brilliant, brilliant educators who really, really care for you. And leaving that is not easy. I have so many brilliant memories of you guys. I'm just going to take a second just to remember a couple of them. The first one came when I was teaching a class for you guys last year, and I was trying to take some good action science photographs so we could put on the science wall. And we're doing methane bubbles. Rebecca Whiffen will not thank me for this. These guys might remember it. I will certainly always remember it. Warren just for the sheer panic I had when it first happened. Too, because Alana, your face is on as well as Deck Kavanagh and Sam Pedersen. And truly, just the sheer hilarity of it. Thankfully, it wasn't that serious in the end, and nobody got hurt whatsoever. You guys remember the Thai fashion show we had? I don't think I've ever laughed as hard or as loud in a lesson. It was absolutely hysterical. I'm probably giving away the secrets that I'm just was a terrible teacher doing silly things in my lessons, but I don't care. It was absolutely brilliant. Here's my little rendition of it. The last one I'm going to mention is without doubt my favourite day in teaching in my career so far. It was something I will never ever forget. It was actually my second last day with you guys, and we had the Year 10 Sports Day. And I just remember feeling that day that, you're going to, apologies for being a bit soppy here, but I remember feeling that day that we weren't acting as a forum, we were really acting like a family. Everybody was putting so much effort in, not for themselves, but for each other. The support you guys showed for each other. I remember so many races where we were getting 1-2s coming through. People who a week before would beg me, oh sir, I really don't want to do that race. We're all of a sudden winning it by a country mile, and I've never felt so proud. And I thank all of you so much for that. It was amazing. I've hated not being there with you through the final year, I really have. Just one or two things that I really, really, really hate that I'm missing or have missed. Welcome to Righty's Words of Wisdom. Okay, I'm going to give you just five pieces of advice that things that I think I have learned since I have been your age, and I would like somebody to tell me these things when I was your age. And so, before we begin, before I start telling you my words of wisdom, let's have a look at our success criteria. Okay, number one, take risks. Anything worth doing should scare the hell out of you. Anything worth remembering will scare the hell out of you. Whether it's asking out someone that you like, that you wanted to for a while, whether it's going for an interview, whether it's going to university or to a new college, whether it's traveling, going to the side of the world, it should terrify you. And I know the best decisions I've ever made are the ones that had me petrified. The first big decision that I'm so glad that I took was moving to England to be a teacher. I think I've told you this, some of you this before, but my mother cried when I did. She was terrified of me going, but now she can't imagine me staying. She's been brilliant for me. The second one I did was I took a massive risk in going to Farnham. I'd never heard of it. I was training up near Manchester. All of a sudden, this small town in Surrey I'd never heard of. I took a job there not knowing anyone. I'm so glad I did. The third big risk I've taken is, and it was incredibly difficult, probably the hardest one of all of them, but it was leaving Ohio, leaving you guys, and coming to China. But by doing it over here, I've had incredible opportunities and I've been able to build myself a brilliant, brilliant, brilliant life. Alright, so I just want to show you some of the things that I've been doing since I've been over here. I swear she's destined for the screen. Closest thing to Michelle Pfeiffer that you've ever seen. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taking away to the dark side. Okay, so scare yourself, test yourself, take risks. Life, you only have one life, do not waste it. Alright, keep pushing yourself to the limits. Set yourself challenges that you don't think you can do. My big challenge at the moment is I'm trying to learn Chinese. Let's have a look. Ni men hao. Ji ge ji nin qi zong xie. Hei mi fan. Oh, hen hao. Ni men hao ma. Wo shu mama hu. Piece of advice number two. Love what you do. Whether that's the subjects you do at A-level, whether that's what you want to do at university, or whether it's your career, you need to love what you do. I always think you need to have two great loves in your life. You need to love what you do, you need to love who you marry. That is just important. You need to have passion for them. Okay? If you love it, that's what's going to bring out the best of you. You guys, right now, are the future. You have so much potential, you have so much talent, you can do what you want to do. I was incredibly lucky. I came into teaching at 20 years old. I love it. I love it. I get to meet people like you. I get to interact with you. I get to know you. I get to see you growing into young adults. And it's amazing. You guys need to just find out what you have that passion for. When you find it, when you find something that you just want to do, do it. Piece of advice number /3. I just want you to remember. I want you to remember who you are. I want you to remember where you came from. The world is literally yours. You are the future. You are young. You are talented. There's no reason you can't become everything you want to be and more. Remember who you are. Remember where you came from. Remember the type of person you want to be. Remember the music that makes you happy. Listen to it. Remember the places that make you happy. Go there. Remember the people who make you happy. Keep in contact with them. When you look around the room now, in 5-10 years time, you will have lost contact with almost everyone. Sad, it's unfortunate, it's life, it just happens. I don't know why, but it just happens. However, if you have 1, 2, 3 really, really close friends, remember who they are, put in the effort, keep in contact with them, because they are going to be the people who are going to help you become the person who you want to become. My fourth piece of advice, to me, is the most important. It's a quote I read from Roosevelt about 3 or 4 years ago, and it really stuck with me. So my advice to you is, do not not care. The quote is so good, I don't actually really remember the words of it, but it goes something like this. There's no good being able to see what's happening in the arena. There's no good being able to point out what's happening in the arena. There's no good criticizing the arena. It's about being in the arena. It's about being, about putting yourself in there. It can be hard doing things sometimes. It can be hard putting yourself out there. Alright? Because sometimes you're going to fail. Who cares? We learn more from failure than we do from success. Results do not define you. Results are not going to decide your future. Now that you have finished your GCSEs, I'm going to let you in a little bit of a secret. The results of your GCSE are going to matter more to you than they will to anybody else. You might open up your GCSE results in August and you might have very good results. That doesn't matter. It's when you can open up your GCSE results and say, I got the best results I could have. That is when you are a success. That is what employers want in the future. Okay? It's the ability to put yourself in there and put everything into it, getting the blood, the sweat, the tears. That is the character you build. That is what is important. There was a great example this year that I missed. Year 11 football team. I was there for, I watched you in semi-finals in year 8, year 9, year 10. You've lost out really closely, just losing out to Tomlin's coach. Through those failures, you were learning, you were building your characters. You guys came back this year. You guys won it in the final in extra time. I was so happy when I found out. All right, well done to each and every one of you. Jack, Charles, I was so proud of you. It's that character that they have built that is the important thing. If they can take that example into the rest of their lives, you guys can take that example in the rest of your lives. My God, you guys will be a success. My final piece of advice. I know I've been waffling on for ages here. Girls, I know you have dresses to put on and makeup to do and all that weird stuff. Okay, so I'm almost finished. My final piece of advice is smile. Nice and simple, smile. Life is what you make of it. Okay, if you have a positive outlook in life, if you're a glass half full type of person, life is going to be so much better. Do not let things weigh you down. Do not always look at the negatives. Look at the positives. It's much, much better. Walk around with a smile on your face. People will smile back at you. You're just going to be much happier. It has been a pleasure knowing you. I have so many great memories, okay? You're a credit to yourselves, you're a credit to your family, and you've been a credit to the school. I want you to go enjoy the rest of your day. You absolutely deserve it. I'm going to be back. I fly into London on the 14th of July. If any of you are around on the 15th of July, it's a Tuesday, I'm going to go to the school. If you're around, come and see me. I'd love to speak to you. I'd love to see how the rest of your year went, but I wasn't there. Okay? As you graduate to begin anew, best of luck, guys. Bye bye.